Thank you very much. We delivered the lesson as we planned as a group. And from the flow of the lesson, I noticed the recap that according to my own observation, because he done the way we planned it. Then he came to the introduction. I think there I noticed it was some sleep in me at the time. Prepare our video next time. So next time I think it's important we discuss that. I think going off, that's okay. That's okay. Maybe we should do. Feel free, we discuss as a group how our lesson was. Thank you very much.
Sure. Okay. That was the presenter's comments concerning the flow of the lesson. Now, let me bring it down to the how was the lesson itself? Beginning from the beginning of the AI, the lesson development, inclusion, then how we can work as a whole. So quickly, let's try to discuss it with my yes, Mr. Amud.
One weakness I saw was that the reference to the video clip wasn't much. I thought people when he last inquired about global warming, acid rain and so forth, I think it should have prepared the videos. Those chimneys we saw, those gases coming out from the video and the lesson will be connected.
Providing an answer to each question that was asked. In very few instances, he would throw the question asked by back to you. Sometimes it's best to get the answer from the pupil so that you can draw a conclusion from the knowledge that they already have. And it becomes more consolidated because it's something which is already up there in their mind. So maybe to ask for, we might consider trying to develop the habit of throwing back the question back to the learners and drawing a conclusion from the already existing knowledge.
Great.
After classes, introductions, which are very, very difficult to come up with. So, in this case of our lesson, I would suggest that we can use our local environment on the cross cutting issues. We can even take advantage of the environment of the learner in case they going deeper anyhow. We will bring that on as depending on the situation at your local school. If they like relating anyhow, or if it's different, we can also do that on the ground.
Okay, in terms of lesson development, how was it?
My comments are on as a teacher, you need to prepare for your success in press. That's where it can be easy for you to make a presentation to flow smoothly. I've seen that some problems in the first instance, whereby the flow is great. Then again, not focusing on and so as a teacher, you need to prepare in press. So as soon as you start your lesson, you have everything at the back of your mind. Otherwise, some people, even if the teacher is lacking some information, therefore, to make you feel uneasy in your presentation. So therefore, you should make sure as you're preparing, as you're even going to present, make sure everything, your whole lesson has been reviewed and checked all those things that you have in place. That way, it will be much easier for you to start your intro in a better way and to the environment. Thank you.
All right, thank you. Yes, madam.
Yes, madam. what I was taking a lesson to the person. I'll talk about the strength of the lesson. The lesson was so interesting and it involves all the letters. So to share, so to say, it was the benefit of the lesson. Yes.
Thank you.
Yeah, for me, I feel the video was supposed to be yes. Let's say, for example, I'll talk about the effects of pollution. So one, the water pollution. So I feel that maybe it was supposed to be played first. I mean, if instead of watching one of it, maybe you pause it. And for water pollution effects, you pause a bit. Maybe you also even discuss with them as what the effects. Therefore, I think you go to the air pollution.
One thing on the hypothesis. The teacher was right in the answer that the teachers were giving. Both wrong and right, but the teacher, there was one when they had put it, there was one answer which was not right. The teacher did not go back and correct. Of course, the teacher said that it's going to correct, but forgot to go back.
Yes, Mr. Pitt.
I would love first to thank the teacher for the well presented lesson. The topic came out at the end of the lesson, which is the same attitude we are hearing from learners will bring up the topic of the day after a series of those activities that was a class on the part of the teacher. Learners made predictions, that was good again. Connected the lesson with the values, I think at the end of the day, we concluded the lesson together with the teacher, itemizing the values because that just turns out without the value. Why are we learning? I think that came out clearly. The teacher also possessed the powerful questioning skills, mixing bots and lots. That is very good. Low order thinking skills, high order thinking skills. We are catered to our boss in the lesson delivery. Then at some point, the teacher became more active. I think that has optimized. The lesson was teacher-centered. Yeah, of course, we say there can never be a good lesson, but we look at the better parts of the lesson that was good. So, some points, the lesson was learner-centered, most of the areas. At some point, we started this way on global warming now. We went and started the audio. Sorry to use that way. Otherwise, I'm dead to the well presented lessons.
Thank you. Yes, Mr. Big, Mr. Kim.
Yes, I think the presenter on the lesson showed that and the lesson was not delivered, content was okay. However, just few things. When planning, the lesson, one of the methods was required, but I don't know if we stuck with this, because I don't see at any point where we assessed the candidates whether they really inquired for the video or not. I didn't see that. The other thing that also came out so much because of the content he had, at some point he started diving into other concepts, okay, which might, at the end of the day, mislead the candidates. But all in all, the lesson was super.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. Yes, like others have said, the lesson was well presented. But I feel as a group, after asking candidates to list the effects of pollution, those points came from learners. As a teacher, it's important also to have precise points on the same, so that after candidates have brought what they know, then you also now consolidate.
The
lesson was we enjoyed that the teacher also was he had the content, and also there was the interaction between him and the people. But I had a few hiccups, especially But also he was also a very critic, meaning that when he saw that something was wrong on the video, he had to make sure that he had them more so that at least the people, there was an interaction, there was something that they should learn. I just saw this issue, especially on certain examples. Here I can be happy. I can be happy, but when you give out some examples, the people is going to be offended out of that example. So try to look at some of the, can I use this? So all those things should be considered. And another thing that I also wanted us to remind you is that we went somehow off track, especially by looking at the way it was what pattern was, which can be distinctive to what we wanted, because the lesson for today was just about the difference, not to be
on the hypothesis where he was that fast and he never got that.
Thank you so much. Yes, madam.
I'm trying to read the introduction in Syllabus on page 9. It says, integrated science includes cross-cutting issues such as environment, reproductive health, HIV and AIDS, hygiene, substance abuse, water, and sanitation. So my question is, since the cross-cutting issue we are talking about, but not only in causing climate change, when should we teach that cross-cutting issue? Should it be a lesson on its own, or it should be put in the same lesson?
Yeah, it's a question for the group. She's asking, madam is asking. Yes, sir.
Like cross-cutting issues are things that we consider not examining, but they are affecting our communities. So those we just talk about them as they come in a lesson. Anywhere, if a question comes there, you can address that cross-cutting issue. It is not something which is like take all the issues. Each lesson, I think, should have a cross-cutting issue. Questions that you want to talk about.
One time, it's a time of this man. It's a lesson for all of us. We must leave ourselves.
Very good, sir. Yes, sir.
Just a little
lesson.
Mary's answer is important to probe from Mary to justify why she had to find it. And quickly, the teacher went to who said importance, and the teacher quickly validated it and he answered yes. So now you need Mary against her answer. You need to clarify that in conception. One of the ways in which you will make sense is flowing with the other members of the class, not play against. I just want to see you drop off in the video.
Yes.
If you just need to wait, you will understand after you watch the video.
Yeah. Volunteer that you are going to teach. That was very good. Our demo teacher did all the best they could. Yeah. So this is how we conduct it. And that's what it's like. Now, I want to just go through, mind you probably, on the discussion of the first term. Then, as a chair, okay, the facilitator for the day, as you be facilitator, where you are going. Like we asked the demo teacher for that day, how was your lesson? Okay, how was the lesson? But how was your lesson? But how was the lesson? The lesson we prepared is limited. So it was an experience. Like you are planning to say, for me, we are going to Kazama as a group.
but not everyone will be a driver. So when you reach there, you will have to change the driver. Oh, thank you so much. Otherwise, we manage to reach. So the driver, who is the demo teacher, explain how the demo knows, how the experience, where he did well, where he did not do very well. I think that was the exercise. Then, when it comes down to discussion, the first thing to ask the vendors is to identify the good points. Which points? Okay, which points were? We know the lesson is framed in 2-3. We have introduction, development, conclusion, whatever. Let's identify the good points of our lesson. And people will discuss. Then, which areas need improvement? Not what were the negatives out here. Which areas need this one. Of course, there's a presentation in discussing the teacher. Okay? We want to look at the lesson. The way we planned it will be delivered as planned. Okay, if the teacher said, okay, I straight in the introduction, I went supplement. We need to sit down. What made the teacher explain? How best can we refine our introduction so that next time he's not going to go straight? The teacher had a lot of content. At one time, the problem is on. What are the cut points which we can do so that it doesn't? Is it that our planning? You know, when we are planning, you may think you are planning a data center lesson. What made him do a bit of me? Our framing of our lesson plan. Say, what needs to make me a time to take in the lesson person? So how are we going to rephrase our activities so that our lesson becomes a QQ or learner syntax? So those are the dimensions. Then you have to ask yourself, like, what is the key area of concern? Lack of understanding informatic information. What were the key concepts which was fitting in this lesson? A lot of concepts came out, if you saw. But were the key concepts addressed in our lesson? If not, how are they going to be addressed in the next lesson? When you say how, you go back now to the lesson so now you can enrich it. Okay, so those are the processes. So, base your arguments on our lesson, not the teacher. Otherwise, the issue of what they have been on the conception, the director talked about that. The issue of mobbing, then the issue of fighting. You saw you're not fighting there, you do not qualify. Then it happened. Let's look at the body plan. Okay? You'll see the body plan. When learners were giving out answers, those answers are supposed to be written on the board. No wonder there is provision to leave space where you are going to write it, inputs from the learners. Those answers did not come from the discussions. Remember those discussions? Uh-huh. Answers from the learners are supposed to be pressed. You can leave that. Okay? And it is good. Sometimes you struggle before space finished. So have that in mind. Our friends' boards, they are so big, sometimes the entire classroom can have the board. So in our case, if we discover that there are so many, it is easy. You know, like if in the last week, the lesson notes have remained. But there were some points which remain there on there, and we could have done that. But so far, so good. I think that's the best way. I like the way the process went on. Even as we go in our schools, let's go.